Okay, so I downloaded an app called Creepy One where you can read creepy pastas. It has classic ones, new ones, it even has filters for searching, but it has no search though, so you have to browse for the one you want. But anyways, we are going to read 4 uncommon creepy pastas.
Lifeless City by K.I. Simpson.
Do you have someone you hate? Someone you would do anything to hurt? Pay any price for vengeance? If so, you may want to consider visiting Lightless City. To get there, go to any decent-sized city and find a deserted alleyway at night. Go into it and close your eyes as tightly as you can. Whisper Lightless City and concentrate on the darkness. You've probably noticed that there are faint colors and abstract shapes you can make out if you try to focus your eyes when they're closed. Watch those images go by. After a few minutes, the images should start to get clearer and brighter. When this happens, they'll start taking on detailed forms, images of violent murders, deformed animals, and similar things. No matter what you see, keep your eyes closed. You'll start to lose track of time, but eventually the images will stop, and you'll see pure darkness. Nothing but deep black, no colors or shapes. When you're certain that you see pure darkness, open your eyes. You will now be in a very dark city. There won't be a single light or star in the sky. You should be able to see a faint, dark blue outline of the tall buildings surrounding you. Make way out of the alley and walk as quietly as you can down the sidewalk in any direction. If you hear any movement, run as quickly as you can. Run away from the noise. There are animals in Lifeless City. It is too dark to make out the details, but they're the size of large wild felines and will kill any human they catch. Keep moving until you reach an area with similar buildings on the edge of the city. A child will approach you, his face dully glowing and letting you see that he is eyeless. He will ask, "Will you share your light with me?" Say yes, the child will reach for your face and rip out your right eye. It will be painful, but there shouldn't be any bleeding or open wound. The child will thank you and leave. Keep walking and a tall man will appear before you. Whose light do you wish to have taken away? Speak the name of the person you hate, and as soon as you say their name, they'll go completely and irreversibly blind. Is your hatred satisfied? The man will ask. If it is, say yes, and you will awaken in the alleyway. If not, say no, and the man will disappear. Keep walking. You will come across another eyeless child. Will you share your light with me? Say yes, and your left eye will be torn out, leaving you blind. Keep walking, and the tall man will appear again. Although, of course, you have to rely on his voice. Whose life do you wish for the darkness to claim? Say the name of the one you hate and they will die. You will not be asked if your hatred is satisfied this time and you will not be able to return to the alley. I've told you to make sure you really hated someone before doing this. You will spend the rest of your time wandering around Lightless City, blind, only your hatred to keep you warm. For some people, that's enough.
That was a really good creepypasta, in my opinion. Who's someone that you hate that you would want gone? For me, it's a man from my early childhood.
Why not we do a funny creepypasta? This one's about Duolingo, and it's by Alex Hanman.
I do not want to live without my cheese slicer. The cats are wearing shoes. The vegetables do not like the vegetarians. Sometimes Duolingo, my smartphone language app, comes up with strange sentences. It always made me laugh, but lately there's been a weird glitch with the app. I've been refreshing my German. My mother is a retired German teacher and spoke it to me growing up. However, now at 29, after years of almost no contact after I got married, she says she's not homophobic, but gee, what a coincidence that she started acting distant after I married a woman. Then finally, somewhat patching things up, I have forgotten a lot. I don't want to lose my knowledge, and German can be useful for work. I decided to take the placement test, then start from the basics again. My understanding is great, but I can't spell and have little grasp of grammar or the gender of items. Everything in German has either a masculine, feminine, or neutral gender. It is the pain in der Ash, I think it's called. Anyway, the weird glitch I have been experiencing has to do with the questions that require one to speak in the language being studied. The app works fine, as does my microphone. I get the answers right. But I don't think whatever the app is having me say is ordinary German. My skills might not be where they should be, but I know that German sounds. But I know what German sounds like. This sounds similar, yet at the same time very different. It is written out in the same alphabet as German, but sounds older, rougher. I have recognized the word Valhalla a few times. The vowel sounds are different as well. Side note, there's a word that's spelled V-A-L-H-A-L-L-A. I don't know how to pronounce it, but I did my best. Anyway, let's get back to the story. Okay. My punctuation is getting better, though. Still, this is confusing. I wrote a note to the app. Maintenance said, I think there's a problem with their German course. Some of the speaking practice don't. Questions aren't in German, but another language, possibly Nordic in origin, and I sent them a screenshot of one such question. The response was quite quick. We didn't put that in there. Are you sure your app is up to date and you're not using a hacked version or playing a joke for the internet? Ooh, that sounds spooky, a hacked version. Okay, anyways, I guess I should have waited until after April Fool's Day to send it in the report, to send in the report of this weird glitch. But since I don't want to lose my 268-day streak of practicing, and the rest of the program is fine, I kept using Duolingo. However, I did send a screenshot and recording of the app pronouncing the weird words for me to my brother, who has traveled a lot, and to a German professor at my former university, hoping he would share it around with professors from other languages as well. While I waited for responses and kept at it, weird things have happened. Okay, global warming has been causing weird weather patterns lately, but whenever I practice outdoors and say one of the weird phrases, I hear thunder or see lightning, and often a storm starts soon after. If I am working on it while walking or working out, I seem to hear a second set of footsteps behind me, a separate breath. This was unnerving, of course. So I tried to stop using the app, though. I mourn the loss of my by now 280-day streak. It didn't work. I lost some time the next day, and when I, for lack of a better word, woke up, I found myself in the middle of a lesson. I can't seem to stop using it. And today I saw something strange. I was practicing it and came across one of the strange phrases while sitting on my patio, looking at a field in the park across the street. There was a clap of thunder that shook my eyes in their sockets, and I saw a huge half-formed gray figure come down from the sky. But it vanished a moment later as I stumbled over how to pronounce my last word. A few minutes ago, I heard back from both my brother and the professor. My brother thinks the glitch is just Icelandic being mixed in, and after I sent him more of them, he still thinks that, though he's confused by the total absence of modern words in what is supposed to be a 21st century language app. The professor has shared the glitch around until finally it reached a medieval history colleague of his. I received an email by both of them copied onto it. It's Old Norse, and given the strange happenings and the fact that I can't seem to put Duolingo down, I'm afraid of what will happen when I finally get the pronunciation right. So I think the app, or like whatever causing her to say these words, is a form of not a form of a curse, but it's a form of a spell or like a craft. So like she could be saying something that can like cause a spell,
Like, it's witchcraft. Like, that's all I think I can say. It's witchcraft. It's a form of magic art. But I guess it wasn't as funny and goofy as I thought. But this is a great story, too.
All right, everybody. I'm going to read two smaller creepypastas now. Starting with Hidden by Idioque.
You do it. You don't know why, but you do. You make sure the windows are locked. You check the other side of the door in your closet. You even check under your bed. Why do you do this? Does ripping open the shower curtain and seeing nothing there make you feel safe? Does scoping the area with your eyes after reading a scary story reassure you? Well, it shouldn't, because by the time you've looked, I have already hidden. Home Alone by Anonymous. You are home alone and you hear on the news about the profile of a murderer who is on the loose. You look out the sliding glass doors to your backyard and you notice a man standing out in the snow. He fits the profile of the murderer exactly and he's smiling at you. You gulp, picking up the phone to your right and dialing 911. You look back out the glass as you press the phone to your ear, and you notice he is much closer to you now. You then drop the phone in shock. There are no footprints in the snow. It's his reflection.
I read all of these at like 2, 3 a.m., like literally in the dead of night. But if you enjoyed this video, why not check out some of my other content? If you like spooky content in general, why not subscribe? My content ranges from narrations to even video games. Thanks for watching!